Less fuel, more money. That's the goal for some Toledo City Council members who say they want to switch the city's fleet of vehicles to electric.
Silver Barker talked to council members today about the idea and joins us live in studio. Silver, it sounds like you heard from at least one council member who's not on board yet. Who is that?
Well, Melissa and Jeff, I spoke with council member George Saranto. He says he's not opposed to electric vehicles. He just thinks the timing is not right to try and make that change.
Turning city vehicles electric. It's a plan on Toledo's agenda, but not on everyone's approval list.
Only 6.8% of EVs are sold in the United States. Clearly, we're seeing that consumers are not going to buy these EVs in the masses.
Councilmember George Saranto says with so much uncertainty, it is not the time to start mandating city departments to purchase electric vehicles.
We just had a national election, and I think the message was quite clear for most voters, and that was that they really are tired of having EVs shoved down their throat.
Saranto also says he worries the upfront cost would be more than traditional gasoline-powered and diesel-powered vehicles. Councilmember Nick Komives, who came up with the proposal, says pushing departments to replace old vehicles with electric vehicles would save money in the long run.
It doesn't require as much maintenance on electric vehicles, so we'll save money there. The federal government is offering a tax credit that we can take advantage of. And then by saving on the fuel cost through the life of the vehicle and having lower maintenance.
Next year's budget allocates more than $1 million in city vehicle replacements. City documents show the city is on track to waste about $500,000 on cars just idling around the city. However, Komives says he believes that amount is closer to $1 million. City Sustainability Manager Dana Rising works closely with Urban Beautification, one of the departments with the most gallons of fuels wasted so far this year.
A lot of times it will be just 10 minutes of idling and that accrues over time. Sometimes it is somebody may be approached by a resident or something and they end up, you know, leaving their vehicle for a half hour, hour at a time.
Rising says EVs would also automatically shut off after a certain amount of time for combustion engines.
But it's not really just about money. It's also about our air quality and what we're breathing in and our environment. So it's really a win-win across the board for us.
A win in question to others.
There's not a wide variety of EV vehicles available right now. So with this proposal, it would seem that we're going to have to take our city dollars, taxpayer dollars, and buy non-UAW vehicles. And I think that's a real slap in the face to the working men and women at our Jeep plant and our General Motors plant and the Ford plants that are in our region.
Now, today was the first reading of this ordinance. Komives tells me the city plans to vote on it in 2 weeks. In studio, Silver Barker, WTOL 11.